Hello, friends. It's a brand new week for us to do devotions together. Do you want to see our new picture? Because we got to turn the page, so we have a new spread here. Do you see that we have a whole bunch of wild animals? I wonder how that's going to play into our lesson. And it looks like they're carrying decorations for a Christmas tree. Do you use these kinds of decorations on your Christmas tree? Oh, when I was growing up, we did. We don't use these anymore on my Christmas trees here in my house with my husband, but we used these when we were growing up. Okay, let's get into our devotion for today. And as you know, they always start off with a question. The question is this: I wonder, how do love and Christmas go together? Let's find out. How do you show love to other people? Do you give them a big squeezy hug and say, "I love you"? Do you buy them a gift? Do you draw them a picture? Well, words and actions, they go well together, don't they? Now, how does God show His love for us? Well, He shows us with words and actions. At Christmas, God's words of promise came true. He acted. In the Bible, God tells us that He sent His Son as a gift to be our Savior from sin. Years later, on a cross, Jesus acted. He died. He paid for our sins, for our unloving thoughts, words, and actions. God forgives us through faith in Jesus. He gives us the victory over sin, death, and the devil. Yes, love came down from heaven to earth at Christmas. We can rejoice. We can sing, "God loves me dearly, loves even me." Oh, friends, now let's practice saying some words together, some words of God's together. Yes, God's word. So we're going to recite together. I'll say it first by myself, and then you'll say it with me two times. This is very familiar, okay? Some of us might just be learning it, and others of us have known this for a few years now. So it is John 3:16. That's right. Okay, I'll say it first by myself, but if you already know it, you jump in with me, and then we'll say it two times together. Okay. God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, that whoever believes in Him will not perish, but have eternal life. Now let's say it two times together. God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, that whoever believes in Him would not perish, but have eternal life. One more time. God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, that whoever believes in Him would not perish, but have eternal life. Good job, friends. Now we have a do it. It says, sing the hymn, "God Loves Me Dearly." Now that might be new to some of us, but I bet others of us know it really, really well. You can Google it. You can look it up in a variety of places. You might even talk with your piano player, your organist at church, and maybe they can play it for you before or after service. That would be a great way for you to visit a little bit with that staff member at your church. Ooh, that would be great. And the song goes a little like this, just to get you started. God loves me dearly, grants me salvation. God loves me dearly, loves even me. Does that sound familiar now? Yes. Okay. Now let's flip to the back of our Advent book. Do you see that we have some of these pages are flipped up, and some of them are not flipped up. They're still tight on the page. Okay, let's see what we have for today. I'll just lift these up to give us a little reminder. This was yesterday's. Okay, now here is today's. Oh, it's a heart. Because God loves us. That's right. That's right. Remember, our question at the very top today was, I wonder, how do love and Christmas go together? Now we can answer that question, can't we? Oh, this is so good. And now, after the video ends, this is our prayer prompt. So this is what you'll pray by yourself or with whomever is around you, okay? It says this. It says, thank God for Jesus, His loving gift. Then ask Him to help you share God's love. This is so good. I love you so much, friends, and I'll meet you right back here tomorrow. Bye.